For most people, their pets are simply an extension of the family, treated sometimes just like their children. However, there is a dark side to the pet industry, and unfortunately, Iowa plays a role in that. Tonight, KWW anchor reporter Colin Dorsey takes a look at Iowa's puppy mill problem.
There are a lot of lists you want to be at the top of. This isn't one of them. The Humane Society of the United States releases an annual report titled The Horrible 100, detailing problem puppy breeders in the United States. Iowa ranked third worst on the list for having these bad breeders.
And there's a very big disconnect between how the puppy mill views the dog and then how the family who gets one of those puppies views their dog.
Tight, cramped cages, unsanitary conditions, and neglect, all characteristics of puppy mills. Iowa has 11 on the list.
At the USDA level, you can still keep a dog in a cage only 6 inches longer than her body, and that's entirely legal.
John Goodwin is with the Humane Society of the United States, which, according to Charity Watch, spends about half of its money on overhead, meaning half goes to saving animals. Iowa only beaten by Ohio with 16 puppy mills, and Missouri with 22. This year's report looked at state citations, though some states could be lax in their enforcement, especially during the pandemic.
States who were, frankly, sometimes doing a better job of enforcement ended up with more entries in the report. So, you know, in some instances, it may be that Iowa inspectors were just doing a better job than the federal inspectors.
Remember the 2018 Samoyeds from Worth County? More than 150 were rescued from the puppy mill and housed at shelters across the state like Cedar Bend Humane Society in Waterloo.
A lot of times we see some pretty serious medical conditions. Some dogs are emaciated, they're matted, eye issues, just overall unhealthy.
Cedar Bend Medical Supervisor Amber Lang was there for the Samoyeds and says taking in dogs like these costs a lot of money.
You know, it comes down to funding and donations, and we ask the public for help because we can't do it alone. And so then when we try to fix everything, it does require a lot of money on our end, so it puts a huge stress on the shelter and our funding.
Solving that problem would mean putting an end to puppy mills and bad breeders, something that would require greater enforcement and tougher laws. The Iowa Pet Alliance works with the good breeders and lawmakers to lobby for stronger animal welfare laws to try and stop Iowa's puppy mill problem.
What we're trying to do is create more communication and create a system that has more uniformity as far as enforcement goes.
Right now in Iowa, who oversees breeders is a bit murky and depends on who your clientele is.
If you are selling puppies to a third party, let's say a pet store, or you're selling them sight unseen online, you go through the USDA to get a license in order to do that. Smaller commercial dog breeders in the state go through a state licensure process with iDolls.
That would be the Iowa Department of Agriculture and Land Stewardship. For the USDA, they're governed by the Animal Welfare Act that's more than a half a century old.
Under the Animal Welfare Act, there aren't always enough inspectors to, I guess, hold those bad actors accountable. And the state level oversight is minimal of those facilities.
Iowa lawmakers have put forth some legislation to protect animals considered pets, but puppy mills sometimes move around, crossing state lines, and like a game of whack-a-mole, can be hard to squash. Until then, shelters like Cedar Bend will continue to take in animals lucky enough to be rescued.
What we generally get would be the older dogs that have been in the facility for quite some time. So a lot of times, it is a lot of unsocialized animals with medical conditions that have gone on for a very long time.
There's also the issue of puppy laundering. That's where puppy mills funnel dogs through fake nonprofits, and they're adopted out as rescues, charging you huge fees and pocketing the profits. Iowa Attorney General Tom Miller sued two of them in one.
Yeah, Colin, thanks for the update tonight. By the way, Illinois U.S. Senator Dick Durbin introduced the Puppy Protection Act. Now, that does modify the existing Animal Welfare Act for the United States. It adds additional requirements for puppy dealers and has been referred already to the Committee on Agriculture, Nutrition, and Forestry at the government level.